itself. The tool is called Remix. We will use this for our contract development. Remix for contract development. Open the Remix ID by typing in the following URL in your browser. I will go to the next slide. Fata fata. So in the center window, you will see some default code, which is a sample Solidity code. You will type your contract code in this code editor. Your code may be auto-compiled. Upon successful compilation of the code, you will be able to run the code in the same integrated development environment. When you execute the contract methods, the results will be displayed in the same IDE window. There are facilities to debug the code and to unit test your project. This can be seen in the menu bar at the top right hand side, as shown in the IDE screenshot below. You will be using these options shortly. So you will now start writing your contract. So Solidity is basically used here. So for quick understanding of the Solidity syntax, look at the sample code in the IDE. Pragma Solidity version so and so. Contract name is ballot. The first line is a directive to the compiler. The second line starts the definition of the contract. Within the contract, you declare variables such as address, chairperson. You can also define structures such as proposal and create an array of these structure items. Examine this in the code window. You may then define a constructor which is invoked at the time of instantiating a contract. Constructor uint8 underscore number of proposals public. After the constructor, you will define several methods which are the contract methods. In the sample contract, give right to vote is one such method having the following syntax. Function give right to vote, address to voter, public brace. The public keyword makes this method publicly invocable by any client who has access to the contract. Likewise, the sample contract defines three more methods called delegate, vote, and winning proposal. Examine these for your own understanding of the Solidity syntax. These are the prerequisites to writing your own contract. We will name our contract, my contract, as in the following declaration. Contract, my contract, we will declare two variables as follows. UINT amount, UINT value. The variable amount will hold the accumulated money sent by the contract executors to the contract creator. The value field will hold the contract value. As the executors execute the contract, the value field will be modified to reflect the balanced contract value. In the contract constructor, we set the values of these two variables. Constructor uint initial amount, comma uint initial value, public brace, amount equal to zero and value equal to 1000. Those are the two, initial amount and initial value. As initially the amount collected on the contract is zero, we set the amount field to zero. We set the contract value to some arbitrary number. In this case, it is 1000. The contract creator decides this value. To examine the collected amount at any given point of time, we provide a public contract method called getAmount, defined as follows. Function getAmount bracket public view returns uint brace return amount. To get the balance contract value at any given point of time, we define get balance method as follows. Function get balance bracket public view returns UIND brace return value. Finally, we write a contract method called send. It enables the clients to send some money to the contract creator. Function send UIND new deposit public brace value equal to value minus new deposit, amount equal to amount plus new deposit. Alchna, idhar aa. Wo dilip ka po raha hai, baat kar lena. So value equal to value minus new deposit, amount equal to amount plus new deposit. The execution of the send method will modify both value and amount fields of the contract. The complete contract code is given now. So contract, my contract, base, UINT amount, UINT value, constructor, UINT initial amount, comma UINT initial value, public brace, amount equal to 0 VAC, value equal to 1000, brace. Function get balance bracket public view return UINT return value. Function get amount bracket public view returns UINT return amount. Function send UINT new deposit public value equal to value minus new deposit, amount equal to amount plus new deposit. So that's the particular code. Now you will compile the contract. So once you have written the complete contract code, compiling it in this IDE is trivial. Simply click on the auto compile checkbox in the integrated development environment. Alternatively, you may compile the contract by clicking the button with the title start to compile. If there is any typographic mistake, fix it in the code window. Make sure the code is compiled fully without any errors. Now you are ready to deploy the contract. Ethereum, deploying the contract. Learn how to deploy contract on Ethereum. Click on the run menu option to deploy the contract. The contract name is shown in the highlighted list box. Below this, you will notice the deploy button. Click on it to deploy the contract. The contract will be deployed on the Remix built-in blockchain. You will be able to see the deployed contract at the bottom of the screen. Notice the presence of three method names in this highlighted region. Next, you will interact with the contract by executing the contract methods. So, Ethereum interacting with the contract. When you click the deployed contract, you will see the various public methods provided by the contract. This is shown in the screenshot below. Deployed contracts, my contract at so and so address. Send UINT 256 new deposit. Get amount, get balance. The first method send contains an edit box in front of it. Here, you will type the parameters required by the contract method. The other two methods do not take any parameter, that is get amount and get balance. Sending money, now enter some amount such as 100 in front of the send function seen in the contract window. Click the send button. This will execute the contract send method, reducing the value of the contract value field and increasing the value of the amount field. So deployed contract, my contract at so and so, send how much? 100. The previous send money action has reduced the contract value by 100. You can now examine this by invoking the get balance method of the contract. You will see the output when you click on the get balance button. So deployed contract, send 100. So either 900 ho gaya balance mein. So the contract value is now reduced to 900. Then examining the collected amount, here we will examine the amount of money collected so far on this contract. For this, click on the Get Amount button. So deployed contracts, my contract at so and so address, send 100, get amount 100, get balance 900. So 900 is the value now and 100 is the amount collected. Try a few send operations and examine the contract value and the amount fields to conclude that the deployed contract is executing as expected. So the Remix IDE that you have used so far is good enough for development and initial testing of your contract. For real life contracts, you need to test your functionality against various parameters. Remix cannot create real non-test user accounts to transfer funds between them. You have no control over the configuration of the blockchain created by Remix. You cannot even monitor the execution of the transactions. Remix misses out on several advanced operations. Thus, we need to deploy our contract on a more sophisticated blockchain that provides all these features. And one such blockchain is Ganache, right? G-A-N-A-C-H-E. So smart contracts are digital contracts that automatically process transactions when each of the encoded terms of the agreement is met by the transacting parties. Why do we even need a smart contract? To understand that, consider that you are buying a property for which you need to request a mortgage loan from your bank. Funds approvals and deposit is a multi-step process that involves many parties and lots of regulatory paperwork. You will have to fill in your personal information, contact all the intermediaries involved in the transaction, signatures, and so on. This not only consumes a tremendous amount of time, but also adds up to the total cost considerably. And all of this because there is a lack of trust between the transacting parties. Fast forward to the future, when smart contracts are mainstream and you are planning again to buy a property by taking a loan from a bank, you will be able to verify your identity using your digital identity stored on the blockchain. From the loan approval to the transfer of ownership, every successful transaction will be transacted in a matter of minutes and recorded on the blockchain. This is how smart contracts eliminate the need for trust and make transactions faster and more secure. In the light of the above example, the use of smart contracts make transactions direct, that is, there is no need of intermediaries, cost efficient, time efficient, more secure, and fraud resistant. Right, so these are the benefits that you get from smart contracts. Then key properties of smart contracts. They have the following properties. They are self-verifying due to automated possibilities. They are self-enforcing when the rules are met at all stages. They are tamper-proof as no one can change what has been programmed. Then capabilities. Smart contracts can automate processes done manually, ensure security, reduce relation to trusted intermediaries, support signature accounts to distribute funds as soon as all parties involved confirm the agreement, manage users' agreements, provide utility to other contracts similar to how a software library works, store information about an app, domain registration information, membership records, etc. A smart contract is a program that runs within a blockchain. It contains a set of rules that constitute an agreement made between two or more parties. When these rules are met, the digital contract executes the transaction. It's like a regular application that implements some business rules. Only it uses a blockchain as a database. So identify agreement is the first step. Sorry. Multiple parties identify a cooperative opportunity and desired outcomes. Agreements potentially in scope could include business processes, asset swaps, transfer of rights, and more. Set conditions. Smart contracts could be initiated by the parties themselves or by satisfaction of certain conditions like financial market indices, natural disasters, or event via GPS location. Temporal conditions could initiate smart contracts on holidays, birthdays, and religious events. For the business logic, a computer program is written in a way that the arrangement will automatically perform when the conditional parameters are met. Encryption and blockchain technology. Encryption provides secure authentication and verification of messaging between the parties relating to the smart contract. Execution and processing. In a blockchain iteration, when consensus is reached on authentication and verification, the smart contract is written to a block. The code is executed and the outcomes are memorialized for compliance and verified. Network updates. After performance of the smart contract, all computers in the network update their ledgers to reflect the new state. Once the record is verified and posted to the blockchain, it cannot be altered. It is append only. You can only add to it, but never alter anything to it. The anatomy of a smart contract. Once the program starts running, nobody can modify it. This is another advantage. People can examine the source code to understand what exactly the program does and can know that this code cannot be modified by hackers or viruses because smart contracts rely on blockchain cryptography. So the plain text is sent by the sender. It is getting encrypted as ciphertext. Then it gets decrypted into plain text and then sent to the recipient. So different keys are used to encrypt and decrypt the messages. Recipient's public key, recipient's private key. Building blockchain applications using Ethereum. And an application in an Ethereum platform is referred to as a DApp. The DApp typically comprises of a front-end and a back-end code. The front-end code is developed using programming languages like JavaScript. The front-end code communicates with the back-end code on the blockchain network. The back-end code is referred to as a smart contract and is typically developed using a higher-level language like Solidity. The smart contract runs on the decentralized Ethereum network. The DApp maps to the application layer of our reference architecture. The front-end part of the DApp does not run on Ethereum network. So in an Ethereum context, a DApp could be simply referred to as the smart contract running in the Ethereum network. Smart contract defines and executes transactions in the form of a software code. It comprises of operations that act on the state of the blockchain. This smart contract acts like a digital contract which can be used to move value and ownership of assets between parties in a given network or across networks. The smart contract in an Ethereum network runs inside an Ethereum virtual machine, and it is available on every node in the Ethereum network. Every node has the same copy of the smart contract and runs the same code or the same logic. Solidity is compiled into bytecode that is executed on the Ethereum virtual machine. Then Ether and Gas, of course, to run applications on the public Ethereum blockchain network, you need Ethers. Ether is a form of payment, a digital fuel that client applications need to pay in order to deploy the smart contract and execute its operations. Each operation requires some computation. This computation work is referred to as a gas. Different operations require different gas units, which is auto-calculated by the system. Based on the gas required, the client needs to pay the appropriate ethers. Think of Ether being paid for a gas as a software service fee for executing the code on the network. Ethereum wallet allows you to hold and secure Ethers and other crypto assets created on Ethereum. It also allows you to write, deploy, and use smart contracts. The Ethereum wallet can be mapped to the application layer of our reference architecture, which provides a capability to interact with our Ethereum network. Consensus algorithm in Ethereum, of course, proof of work, proof of stake, and practical Byzantine fault tolerance. Ethereum currently uses the POW algorithm, and the plan is to move to POS in a later release. Ethereum blockchains uses permissionless consensus. Permissionless here means that any node can join and participate in the network and execute or validate the transactions. Out of all the public nodes in the network, majority of the nodes, say 51% out of 100, must agree on the validity of the transaction to arrive at a consensus. Once consensus is reached, the transaction is committed to Ethereum. Now, in the absence of a central governing authority, how can one assure that 51% of these nodes are G9 and no one has added or manipulated nodes to drive transactions in their favor? That is where the proof of work algorithm is applied to drive consensus throughout the network. Given below is an example of the POW algorithm. Let's assume there is a chain of two blocks already committed on the network. A new block, number three, needs to be added to the existing chain. Let's understand the sequence of flow as to how this third block of transaction would be committed. Every node in the network will take up the challenge of creating the third block and committing the same to the blockchain. For this to achieve, each of the nodes will try to solve a mathematical equation. In the context of Ethereum, it is a digest value that needs to be created, and it has to be less than some difficulty level preset by the system. The mathematical equation could be something like the following. The problem to solve is calculate digest 3, which should be less than the difficulty level. The equation and its context, let us assume the difficulty level is preset as something 781. Now the digest 3 is calculated using hash algorithm, say SHA 256, and by creating the hash of the values block 2, digest 2, and nonce. Nonce can be any arbitrary value that is incremented every time the node makes an attempt to find the correct digest 3 value. In short, nonce is incremented to find a solution to the equation. So overview of the solution. Now each node would start solving this equation by incrementing the nonce value. Let's say B3 is the new block to be committed. B2 is the previous block, that is block 2, and D is the difficulty level. If equation is solved, the result is yes, else the result is no. The following snippet shows how a node tries to solve the equation. So it is iteration 1, SHA256, block 3, block 2, comma 1, less than D, outcome is no. Iteration 2, SHA256, block 3, block 2, 2, less than D, outcome is no. And several other iterations taking place. Lastly, iteration 2, 000008, SHA256, block 3, comma block 2, 4508, less than D, and the outcome comes to be yes. The minor node will keep trying until the outcome is yes. It is like a rat race where every node attempts to be the first to get the outcome as yes. As you can see from the above snippet, at nonce value 400008, the equation is solved. That is, the digest 3 value is less than the difficulty level. The node that solves this equation propagates the nonce value of 400008 to all the other nodes in the network for the purpose of verification. All other nodes would simply take this nonce value and verify if it is indeed less than the difficulty level. The other nodes just need one step to verify this equation with least computing power. Once verified, the block will get committed, that is, chained to the previous block, and the miner is rewarded with ethers for the work done by him. Note, as you can see in the above example, the blockchain is a chain of hashes, each linked to previous one. That is, digest of 3 contains digest 2, digest of 2 contains digest 1, and so on. So it's a chain of hashes. Adding a new block in between by an intruder implies changing the entire hash sequence till the very beginning, which seems virtually impossible in this case. Then, phases of blockchain testing. So the first phase is initiation phase, understanding the blockchain architecture. In this phase, we understand and analyze the business and the functional requirements. This describes the behavior of the application and how the user will interact with the application. Then comes full test strategy designing. During this phase, we describe the testing approach for testing an application. This should be done in detail so that every objective are fully covered. Then the design phase, test case creation. In this phase, the quality assurance team writes the test cases with proper steps. These test cases are reviewed by the business analyst. Test data creation. In this phase, test data is created or extracted from the previous environment against the business requirements. Test data can be created manually or using the automation tools. Then comes environment setup. In this step, the testing environment is configured as the need for business or application. Then performance measures or performance metrics. They represent the information in terms of performance of application, system, or the components. Then testing phase, API testing, ensure that the interaction
Hello?
With the application is
important. Hello?
Yes. Yes. Hello?
Hello. Sir, now your voice is coming proper. There was some issue in your voice. You can continue. If something is there, I'll tell you.
हाँ, मेरे को जरा बीच में बोलना ना जरा प्लीज.
जी जी जी
ओके. सो द ब्लॉकचेन इकोसिस्टम इज एज एक्सपेक्टेड. सो एपीआई टेस्टिंग देन ब्लॉक टेस्टिंग. ऑल द ब्लॉक्स ऑन द नेटवर्क शुड बी टेस्टेड इंडिविजुअली टू एंश्योर प्रॉपर कोऑपरेशन बिटवीन देम. देन कम्स फंक्शनल टेस्टिंग. इन फंक्शनल टेस्टिंग वी इवैल्यूएट द वर्क of various functional parts.
Sir, your voice is
fluctuating.
Hello. Yes.
चलो मैं देखता हूँ मेरा माइक्रोफोन ठीक है कि नहीं. देखता हूँ.
जी जी.
Hello, is it audible now?
No, sir.
Is it audible now?
No, sir. It is still having problem.
चलो मैं बोलता हूँ एक सेंटेंस, फिर आप मेरे को जरा रिएक्शन दीजिए. So block testing, all the blocks on the network should be tested individually to ensure proper cooperation. Functional testing. In functional testing, we evaluate the work of various functional parts of the blockchain.
Sir, in the
For
morning
example,
we
smart contracts. Yes.
Sir, in the morning we had the same issue. Same issue as morning. In the morning, the same thing was happening.
So functional testing, in functional testing, we evaluate the work of various functional parts of the blockchain. For example, smart contracts. Then performance testing, details like network latency based on block size, network size, expected transaction size, and how long a query takes to return the output with the specialized authentication protocol. अब क्या है? अब कैसी हालत है?
This is better, sir.
This is better. Okay. So let's see that it becomes more better. Security testing. In this, we ensure that the application is vulnerable to attacks and systems can protect the data and is capable of handling malicious attacks, etc. Then integration testing. In integration testing, we ensure that all the components of the application are integrated properly and performing the actions appropriately as per the requirement of the whole application. Smart contract testing. Smart contract testing is about performing detailed functional testing of business logic and process. So testing phase mein all these type of things are involved. हम दे अलग तरह से भी करते हैं ये सारी testing software में. So API testing, block testing, functional testing, performance testing, security testing, integration testing, smart contract testing. Then comes the report phase. Project summary report describes the overall overview of project details, project dates, cost, and task details. Smart contract testing report. This report describes the details of smart contract data and rules processing. Okay. Hello. Smart contract testing report. This report describes the details of smart contract, data, and rules processing. Then security testing report shows vulnerable information in a formal document for the client and higher management. The report contains the date of testing, test data, and summary of the vulnerabilities found. Then performance testing report, another important report. This report shows the details regarding the performance of applications like speed, scalability, reliability, etc. Then key testing types on blockchain applications, functional testing, integration testing, performance testing, nodes testing, API testing. So I'm just skipping because all these have been discussed in the previous slide also. Then what are the blockchain testing tools? So the number one tool is Ethereum Tester. It is an open source testing library available on GitHub repository. It is easy to set up with manageable API support for various testing requirements. Then Genache, it is earlier known as TestRPC. It is widely used library for testing Ethereum contracts locally. It works by spinning up a kind of mock blockchain that gives you access to accounts you can use for the purpose of testing. And then Hyperledger Composer. Hyperledger Composer is an open source tool that helps developers to build blockchain applications. Using this tool, they can perform mainly three types of testing. One, interactive. Number two, automated unit testing and system testing. Yeah, so now thing that we need to discuss, and that is cryptocurrency. Shall I go further if the things are clear? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Shall I go further?
Yes, please, sir.
Okay, good. Thank you. So the other thing that we need to discuss is about cryptocurrency. So cryptocurrency is electronic money created with technology, controlling its creation and protecting transactions while hiding the identity of its users. Cryptocurrencies are digital cash designed to be quicker, cheaper, and more reliable than our regular government issued money. Cryptocurrency is an internet-based medium of exchange which uses cryptographic functions to conduct financial transactions. Cryptocurrencies leverage blockchain technology to gain decentralization, transparency, and immutability. Right? So these are the three characteristics of the blockchain technology, and cryptocurrencies leverage all these three things, that is decentralization, transparency, and immutability. A cryptocurrency is a digital asset designed to work as a medium of exchange that uses strong cryptography to secure financial transactions, control the creation of additional units, and verify the transfer of assets. Essentially, cryptocurrencies are limited entries in a database that no one can change unless specific conditions are fulfilled. Cryptocurrency is a form of payment that can be exchanged online for goods and services. Many companies have issued their own currencies, often called tokens, and these can be traded specifically for the goods or service that the company provides. Think of them as you would arcade tokens or casino chips. You will need to exchange real currency for the cryptocurrency to access the good or service. A technology called blockchain, a decentralized technology spread across many computers that manage and record transactions, is used for working with cryptocurrencies. Security is the part of appeal of this technology. It's totally secure. You can buy goods, invest money, mine, accept as payment for business purposes with cryptocurrency. There are around 2,900 cryptocurrencies in the world active today. The top 10 has market share of 90%. Index CCI 30, CRIX are the most popular ones. Bitcoin, $BTC, Ethereum, $ETH, Ripple, NEA, IOTA, NEO, Dash, Qtum, Monero, Ethereum Classic, XRP, $XRP, Bitcoin Cash, $BCH, Tether, $USDT, Litecoin, $LTC, US, $US, Binance Coin, $BNB, Bitcoin SV, $BSV, and Stellar, $XLF. The total value of the top 10 cryptocurrencies is $194 billion. $194 billion. It is estimated that by 2025, 10% of global GDP value would be in blockchain technology. There are different trends like industry-specific currency. Examples include oil sector, dental sector, and photography sector, which came out with specific currency for their domain. Cryptocurrencies appeal to their supporters for a variety of reasons. Here are some of the most popular reasons. Supporters see cryptocurrencies such
Hello.
As Bitcoin. Yes, yes, ma'am.
Sir, we have a question from participant.
Yeah, I'll take it. Yeah, boli a question.
Sir, can you give example of test case when we do smart contract testing, performance testing?
Pardon, I could not get you.
Can you give example of test case when we do smart contract testing and performance testing?
See, performance particularly is how efficient your application is and how effective your application is. So, performance ki agar aap baat karo, तो आपने एक पर्टिकुलर एप्लीकेशन बना ली है और उस एप्लीकेशन के पीछे बहुत सारा खर्चा भी हुआ है, पैसे भी खर्च हुए हैं, तो पर्टिकुलरली आपको मेजर क्या करना है परफॉर्मेंस पे कि आपकी जो एप्लीकेशन है वो एफिशिएंट है, जिस पर्पस से वो बनी थी वो पर्पस क्या सॉल्व हो रहा है, नंबर वन. एंड सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ थिंग दैट यू हैव टू मेजर इज इट्स इफेक्टिवनेस. तो आपके जो पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेसेस डेवलप हुए इस पर्टिकुलर एप्लीकेशन से, तो क्या कितना इफेक्टिव वो हो पा रहा है आपका काम. सो टू थिंग्स विच नीड टू बी चेक्ड इन परफॉर्मेंस मैट्रिक्स इज द इफेक्टिवनेस एंड द एफिशिएंसी ऑफ योर एप्लीकेशन. दो चीजें आपको टेस्ट करनी है.
कैन यू गिव एग्जांपल, कैन यू गिव एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस टू टेस्टिंग अंडर द अंडर सम केस स्टडी और सम यूज केस.
या कहिए.
So can you give these two examples under some case, under the context of some use?
थोड़ा जोर से बोलना ना, मेरे को सुनाई नहीं दे रहा बेटा.
Sir, can you give example of these two testing under the context of some use case?
नहीं, use case कोई भी हो सकता है. जैसे say for example आपने real estate का use case ले लिया या retail का use case ले लिया, तो particularly क्या हुआ है कि you are on this particular type of a technology. आपने अपनी application इस technology को use करके बना ली है. अब बेसिकली ये जो आपकी एप्लीकेशन चल रही है, नाउ आई हैव टू मॉनिटर दिस एप्लीकेशन परफॉर्मेंस, राइट? सो व्हेन आई से दैट आई हैव टू रियली मॉनिटर द एप्लीकेशन परफॉर्मेंस, आई मीन टू से दैट हाउ एफिशिएंटली इट इज वर्किंग, राइट? सो से फॉर एग्जांपल इट मस्ट बी अवेलेबल 24/7, मेरा सर्विस लेवल एग्रीमेंट है, राइट, 24/7, एंड से फॉर एग्जाम्पल 2 घंटे के लिए एप्लीकेशन बंद हो गई, तो मेरी जो परफॉर्मेंस मैट्रिक्स है वो सफर कर रही है. सो वंस अगेन व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट व्हाटएवर एप्लीकेशन यू हैव डेवलप्ड, द टू इंपॉर्टेंट टाइप ऑफ फैक्टर्स व्हिच यू नीड टू चेक इन परफॉर्मेंस मैट्रिक्स फॉर एनी टाइप ऑफ यूज केस, एक्स वाई जेड कोई भी यूज केस होगा, तो पहली चीज है कि ये इफेक्टिव है या नहीं, एंड दूसरी चीज है ये एफिशिएंट है या नहीं, क्योंकि इसमें आपका काफी खर्चा हुआ है बनाने में, एंड ये दो परफॉर्मेंस मैट्रिक्स आपको मैनेजमेंट को बतानी पड़ेगी. ओनली देन इट विल बी सेड दैट यस योर पर्टिकुलर परफॉर्मेंस फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर एप्लीकेशन इज डूइंग वेल. कोई भी यूज केस हो सकता है.
ओके सर.
ओके, सो सपोर्टर्स क्या कहते हैं इसके बारे में, क्रिप्टो करेंसी के बारे में? So supporters see cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin as the currency of the future and are racing to buy them now, presumably before they become more valuable. So day by day, the cost of this particular Bitcoin as such is getting more and more costly because of its availability. Some supporters like the fact that cryptocurrency removes central banks from managing the money supply. Since over a period of time, these banks tend to reduce the value of money via inflation. Other supporters like the technology behind cryptocurrencies, the blockchain, because it is a decentralized processing and recording system and can be more secure than the traditional payment systems. Some speculators like cryptocurrencies because they are going up in value and have no interest in the currency's long-term acceptance as a way to move money. So many of the reasons as such are provided by the supporters, right, who support these type of digital currencies or cryptocurrencies. Then different views in different countries. Different countries identify cryptocurrency differently, and some of the important identification attributions are as under. It is not to give a fancy identity to differentiating identity from others. Each country applies taxation on cryptocurrency as per the identification attribution given by them. So, of course, it is paperless currency, virtual currency, alternate currency, it's a digital asset, it's a commodity which can be traded, barter, money, not currency, goods. So cryptocurrency in Israel is taxed as an asset. In Bulgaria, taxes it as financial asset. Switzerland may, it is taxed as foreign currency. Argentina and Spain may, it is subject to income tax. Denmark may, it is subject to income tax and losses are deductible from your balance sheet. In United Kingdom, corporations pay corporate tax, unincorporated businesses pay income tax, individuals pay capital gains tax. So alag alag countries may alag alag views hai iske, and abhi to India mein isko apan mante nahi hai jada cryptocurrency. Then volume and scale of transaction. It is estimated that in the world, USD 200 trillion paper money plus gold worth money exists. cryptocurrency capitalization is in the range of USD 400 billion and soon will be 1 trillion. 24-hour trade volume is in the range of USD 65 plus billion. Right? So paper money plus gold, आप पूरे वर्ल्ड पर इकट्ठा करो तो वो लगभग 200 ट्रिलियन है, 200 ट्रिलियन वर्थ मनी एग्जिस्ट। क्रिप्टो करेंसी का कैपिटलाइजेशन अगर आप देखो आज की तारीख में तो इट इज इन द रेंज ऑफ USD 400 बिलियन एंड विल सून कम टू 1 ट्रिलियन एंड 24 आवर्स ट्रेड वॉल्यूम इज इन द रेंज ऑफ USD 65 प्लस बिलियन। Then the concept of crypto exchange. Crypto exchanges are the financial intermediaries needed to link together different cryptocurrencies while offering clients a web-based centralized gateway to manage their funds. Cryptocurrency exchanges are secure online marketplaces in which users can exchange one kind of digital asset for another based on the market value of the given assets. Cryptocurrency exchanges function in two ways. Number one, peer-to-peer trading, where the seller sets the price. Number two, brokers, similar to currency exchanges, where the platform sets the price, which is market price plus a small premium to be given to the broker or the currency exchange. They allow exchanging one cryptocurrency for another, the buying and selling of coins, and the exchange of fiat money into crypto. Crypto exchanges set the rate of the currencies, both coins and tokens. Also, trading platforms charge fees for withdrawing money from the account. You also have cryptocurrency ATM. A Bitcoin ATM, automated teller machine, is a kiosk that allows a person to purchase Bitcoin by using cash or debit card. Some Bitcoin ATMs offer bi-directional functionality, enabling both the purchase of Bitcoin as well as the sale of Bitcoin for cash. In some cases, Bitcoin ATM providers require users to have an existing account to transact on the machine. There are two main types of Bitcoin machines, one cash kiosk and ATMs. Both types are connected to the internet, allowing for cash or debit card payment, respectively, in exchange for Bitcoins given as a paper receipt or by moving money to a public key on the blockchain. Bitcoin cash kiosks look like traditional ATMs, but do not connect to a bank account and instead connect the user directly to a Bitcoin exchange. According to an advisory issued by the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, they may also charge high transaction fees. Media reports describe transaction fees as high as 7% and exchange rates, $1.50 over rates you could get elsewhere. There are 7,000 cryptocurrency ATMs in the world, with 11 plus new being installed every day. So you have cryptocurrency exchanges, you have cryptocurrency ATM. Now, there are certain questions which we all may be interested in, and of course, the answer will be provided here and here itself. So you are required to prepare a report containing a complete discussion and analysis of the given topic in the required context. The report must have the following parts. Part 1, Ethereum and Bitcoin. Review the literature on the internet as papers, book chapters, and independent scholarly reports by experts and research-based videos, and explore Ethereum and Bitcoin. At least 2 articles related to technology supporting Ethereum need to be analyzed in depth by discussing the overall contribution, scope, and limitations of each research work. The following aspects related to Ethereum must be discussed. Number 1, architecture. Number 2, features. Number 3, the challenges. Then part 2, applications of Bitcoin. You need to discuss at least. Hello?
All right, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. You need to discuss at least 1 application in each of the following domains supported by Bitcoin. Number 1, token system. And number 2, decentralized file storage. And the part 3 of the report says, compare Ethereum and Bitcoin. The 2 biggest giants of the cryptocurrency world are Bitcoin and Ethereum. Bitcoin, BTC, was the first coin, and Ethereum, ETH, followed a few years later. Discuss in detail similarities and differences between the two.
Sir, so again, your voice is fluctuated.
फिर से खराब हो गई?
अब ठीक है.
चलो. अब ठीक है? अब ठीक आ रही है?
जी जी सर.
ओके ओके. सो ये जो 3 पार्ट्स हैं, उसके आंसर भी मैं डिस्कस कर रहा हूँ. Not a problem, right? So that everybody will be clear about it. So Ethereum cryptocurrency में architecture की अगर अपन बात करें, तो the architecture and structure that is followed in Ethereum is quite similar to that of Bitcoin. The nodes that are involved in Ethereum store the most recent state of the smart contracts. Along with the details of the Ether transaction.
Hello.
हाँ जी बोलिए.
Sir, your voice is fluctuating.
Fluctuating. फिर से. अच्छा एक मिनट हाँ मैं थोड़ा 2 sentences पढ़ो फिर बता. It is also necessary that a track of the state and current information is kept and stored in the node. Ethereum makes use of accounts, for instance, in the bank account transactions. The Ether tokens appear in the wallet and can also be ported from one account to the other. How is it now?
Someone is taking the control. Rajalakshmi Jaiswal, please unshare your screen. Yes,
yeah, okay, sorry,
you are sharing, no issues. Sorry,
no,
sir.
It's okay.
Yes. Okay. Amit Jhawar, sir, you can now start. Sorry.
Okay. You can start. So, architecture discuss upon kar rahe the. So, there is a network of thousands of computers that are involved to process when a program is utilized in Ethereum. The smart contracts that are written in a specific programming language are put together, which are referred to as bytecode. Ethereum virtual machine then reads and executes these bytecodes. Every node present in the network comprises of the transaction copy and the history of the smart contract to ensure that current information and state is present. The nodes in the network come together to an agreement to handle the change as a user performs certain action. There is a stack-based bytecode language that is used to carry out the actual computation using the Ethereum virtual machine. There are miners involved in the transaction to make sure that any of the malicious activity is prevented and avoided. Features mein kehta hai, the feature of Ethereum that distinguishes it from the rest of the cryptocurrency is smart contract accounts. It provides the users to carry out the transactions just like the external users and also customize a specific program to manage and administer different set of functions. With this feature of Ethereum, the business groups and individuals develop their own currency. There are a few solutions proposed and presented to make sure that the Ethereum is more scalable and the processing speeds are also improved. The feature that has been included in Ethereum to make sure that every node is not involved in the data verification and transaction processing is called sharding. That's the feature, sharding. The blockchain is therefore divided in shards. This leads to the part of the state to be stored by the node and the processing speed is improved upon. The shards of the blockchain are involved in the processing of specific parts of the entire state. It is, however, necessary to develop a seamless communication mechanism between these shards. A concept and feature of Ethereum called off-chain computations allows a layer apart from the blockchain wherein all the computations and calculations are carried out irrespective of the complexity levels. This assists in the process of load balancing and helps in decreasing the overall cost of the transactions involved. It also makes sure that only particular nodes are involved in the complex computations in place of the involvement of all of the nodes. There are also verifiers engaged who verify the outcomes and solutions. So from proof of work to proof of stake, the proof of work mechanism is associated with the Bitcoins as well as with Ethereum. There are certain drawbacks that are associated with proof of work in terms of transaction speed and scalability. Proof of stake is a feature that is associated with Ethereum in which validators are involved as the owner of the ethers, and these will keep their own ethers at stake at the time of validating a transaction. In case of a failure, the validators lose their own ethers and it does not have any impact on the rest of the transactions and ethers. Then the challenges. The challenges that are associated with Ethereum can be broadly classified in two categories. These include obstacles to mass adoption and scalability issues. The smart contracts feature of Ethereum provides the users to carry out the transactions just like the external users, and also customize a specific program to manage and administer different set of functions. The business groups and individuals develop their own currency with this feature of Ethereum. There are a few solutions proposed and presented to make sure that the Ethereum is more scalable and the processing speeds are also improved. Another concerning issue associated with Ethereum is the inflated transaction costs. There is an issue with Ethereum algorithm to estimate the transaction cost that may result in overpay of transactions by up to 70%. Then applications of Bitcoin may cater token systems. Token system is one of the domains that are supported by Bitcoin. There are several applications that have been designed and developed as a part of this concept. One such application is BitShares. These are the digital tokens that are present on the blockchain and reference particular assets, for instance, specific commodities or currencies. The token holders get the unique features and abilities to earn interest on these commodities. These may be in the form of gold, silver, oil, or the currency instruments, along with dollars, euros, and likewise. The features of the application are price-stable cryptocurrency. Smart coins are used in BitShares that provide the enhanced freedom that comes along with all forms of cryptocurrencies. It also provides the stability that is guaranteed by dollars and euros. The dynamic account permissions application provides the users with the ability to control an account by making use of any weighted combination along with the use of the private key. This feature makes sure that the risk associated with the security are eliminated. There is a built-in support in the application for recurring payments along with the subscription payments in recurring and scheduled payments. The withdrawal of the payments can also be scheduled as per the start and finish dates and the withdrawal limit that is applied. The users are provided with a fast and smooth trading platform through decentralized asset exchange. The other features offered by the application include
Sir, we have a few questions if you can pick it up.
Yeah, sure. Welcome. Boliye.
Sir, what kind of attacks are possible in DApps?
I could not get the question better.
Sir, is there a possibility of DOS attack or some other kind of attack?
Yeah, possible. Denial of service attack, wagera, yeah, could be possible. Not at all. Yeah, could be possible.
Sir, they are totally secured. There is no vulnerability available in this smart contract.
No, absolutely no. They are taken care of. There is no vulnerability.
Okay, and sir, in Bitcoin, we studied there was a double spending attack.
वो अलग चीज है. वो double spending किस तरह से होता है वो समझना पड़े.
Yes, sir. If trusted user does something like double spending activity, so how? But we also know that Ethereum prevents this by providing some, due to its nature of network. It avoids double spending, which is available.
That is once again taken care of.
So which features are there in Ethereum which avoids double spending attack?
इसके लिए आपको थोड़ा और आगे जाना पड़ेगा. आगे की स्लाइडों में वो फीचर्स अपन ने डिस्कस किए थे Ethereum के. Right? So those are the features as such which take care of all such type of things. right? So it's totally secured. Vulnerability is nahi hai isme. Don't worry about it.
Okay, sir.
So the other features offered by the application include industrial performance and scalability, stakeholder approved project funding, user issued assets, transferable named accounts, and delegated proof of stake consensus. Proof of stake is a feature that is associated with the application in which validators are involved as the owner of the accounts, and these will keep their own accounts at stake at the time of validating a transaction. In case of a failure, the validators lose their own accounts and it does not have any impact on the rest of the transactions and accounts. Decentralized file storage mein kehta hai, another domain that is associated with Bitcoin is decentralized file storage. One of the applications that have been developed under this domain is Augur. Augur is a decentralized prediction market that provides the users with the ability to purchase and sell their shares on the basis of the anticipation of an event and the associated likelihood of an outcome that will come up as a result of the event. The application can also be used for the purpose of financial forecasting on the basis of wisdom of crowds. There are several features that are associated with the application. So political forecasting is one, event hedging is another, weather prediction, company forecasting. The cycle followed to carry out a specific function in Augur always starts with the selection of the event, followed by the creation of a market. Buy and sell shares and reporting the outcome are the next step, set of steps involved. And the last step involved is claiming of the winnings.
Hello.
Ah, ji.
Sir, okay. Sir, we do have 10, 15 more minutes. So, will you be able to wind up this session by 10, 15 minutes?
No, no, I'm wind up. This is the last slide. This is the last slide.
Okay, no issues, sir.
Ah, yeah, last slide. So Ethereum is a cryptocurrency in which every node present in the network comprises of the transaction copy and the history of the smart contract to ensure that current information and state is present. As a user performs certain action, the nodes in the network come together to an agreement to handle the exchange. Sharding is one of the features of Ethereum. It is one of the features of Ethereum that has been included to make sure that every node is not involved in the data verification and transaction process. The blockchain is therefore divided in shards. This leads to the part of the stake to be stored by the node, and the processing speed is improved upon. The challenges that are associated with Ethereum can be broadly classified in two categories. These include obstacles to mass adoption and scalability issues. Bitcoin is another cryptocurrency that is widely used. The application areas of Bitcoin include token systems, decentralized file storage, and many others. BitShares is one of the applications of Bitcoin, which includes the digital tokens that are present on the blockchain and reference particular assets, for instance, specific commodities or currencies. The token holders get the unique features and abilities to earn interest on these commodities. So this was the last slide of my presentation.
Okay, sir.
So thank you all for participating in such a big number. All faculty members, as I have promised you something, I will definitely do it in coming days. I will be in touch with Payal. Right, so that will be taken care of. Right, so kuch demo wagera ho sake to main kar sakta hu to karunga zarur aapke liye. Right, so thank you very much. Have a nice day. And abhi aapka do din aur chalega. Right, so gain the knowledge that will be shared by other experts also. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you. Yes, sir. It's my pleasure to say thank you very much on behalf of all our participants. Amit Johri sir, really you have just given a very inspired as well as very detailed speech. Actually, I belongs to somewhat a different area, but even I have got very in-depth idea about the same session. It was really very inspiring as well. So we hope that definitely you will just always be with us as and when it is required, and sir, definitely will be tried to be in touch with you. Thank you very much, sir. Once again, thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor. Thank you very much.
Yes, yes.
And goodbye to everybody of you. Everybody of you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.